Leaders have asked the judiciary to decentralize judicial services in districts in order to bridge the gap between people who are trekking long distances to access justice in court.
With the team of your colleague, Mr. Kiria, we are being promised that as we speak, this was approved and it is going to be worked upon. However, we also have an issue of our prosecutor. He has no license. Then, going forward, there are some cases that we have that come in, and when some people come to us and we tell them you're going to court, they tell us, then because there we have our contact, they will help us.
During open day session, which was organized by International Justice Mission, a non-profitable government organization, it was discovered that districts in Rwenzori sub-region are ranking highly in crime rate.
Recent studies have showed that in Kamwenge, issues of violence against women and children are very high. Actually, Kamwenge is ranked fourth across the country, which is not good. I believe with these different activities that are being planned alongside the different stakeholders, Kamwenge should not be among the top four. We know in time Kamwenge is going to be dropping to at least numbers that are far from the top. And we ask the community to work hand in hand with justice officials so that we can end the violence against women and children in our district.
According to Vincent Wagona, a resident judge at Fort Portal High Court, their offices have limited manpower compared to the cases they receive. At Kamwenge Magistrate Court, over 152 cases are received every month, and Fort Portal High Court receives over 300 cases every month.
When I came on day one, I was given my 320 cases in October. Of course, there are more now. In October, I was given 320. So I sat down and did an analysis. I established that 80% of the cases are land-related. Even the criminal cases we have are arising from those land wrangles. The other thing I established was that most of the cases are from within the family, from within the same family. Son is suing mother for land, grandson is suing grandfather for land, and so on.
However, he said the plan of recruiting judges has been a concern that is cutting across, but assured residents that soon they will avail services of the High Court in Kamwenge District.
Important, and it is a welcome gesture. The resident judge based in Fort today gave us that promise and the centralization of administration of justice to the lower courts is another remedy through which we can minimize these court cases. Because look at the situation where somebody carries around 5 witnesses to go to Fort Portal, and you go there, it is postponed for 2 months, you go again 2 months. At the end of the day, those who are disadvantaged in terms of resources, they will end up losing the case automatically. That's the guarantee, and especially these young ones and women. Those are sure tickets that they are going to lose the case when the matters are referred to go to court and to looking for higher levels.
According to how I learned from this court day of opening, we need to have these sessions as how we have it today to teach these local people at our villages, and they get to know how these issues and how these cases and how we can stay together without making wrangles with them and destroying our properties and being poor because of entering into something which we don't know, and being guided with these people who knows very well the law.
Residents commended leaders and judges for organizing the open court day session, saying they have acquired knowledge and procedures of accessing the court. This story was compiled by Anthony Atwine for the news.